Advental Code Day 7. Close this. Duplicate this. Rename the file as in puzzle 7 test. Okay. Uploading the file. Save it. And the day 7. Towers of Hanoi. Other program is called on this. So on. The very tops. Any programs can be kept below them. Balanced. A program holding a disk, and on that disk balanced several sub towers, and a disk is balanced by the programs that stands on that disk. Okay. So the program has name, weight, and the collection of subtowers. The name of program is okay. So my puzzle input will be a list of until I decide, of course. Out of order. Okay. So this one is the root. So the first. Okay. What is the name of the bottom program? Let's see how the puzzle input looks like. What is that? Right here. Parsec! I can do it with a regex, but it's not finding that. So, today, puzzle, we will use fparsec. Okay, what is the sample? Here. I have a sample. And I will have to check several things to check that I'm parsing correctly a list. And to check reaction and response. So this is also an input correct input. So maybe just that. So I'll have that. Okay, and the expected name is okay. Let's see. Sign into one list. I forgot. Sorry, guys. I forgot to increase the font size. So for the moment you didn't last anything if the fonts were too small. I just write the test. Nothing more. And this one, let's say like this. To fail. Okay, so the first sample test will be find the root of sample, and the expected value will be that one. I will have two failing tests at this moment. Let's see them failing. Okay. Let's see how to implement this. The fastest way will be to take only parents. So I will filter this entire collection by rows that have the arrow. That means that I will have parents here. And after that, to take all the childs from those rows and create a set with those childs, a single set. And I will find the root by searching all the parents that don't exist in that set of childs. This will be the fastest implementation for the first part. But where is the fun in that? I want to build the tree. So I will implement both of those. So I my first thing will be to just make that to find that solution. After that, I will create the tree. It's a lot more fun. Let's see, find the root of input. First of all, I need to learn how to read these two kind of rows. So let's take those rows and use them as a test. What the read row will do? Will return a structure of type leaf of LJ and 57. For the moment, and this thing return a node with and an array of I don't know if this is going to be the final structure. I will refactor the test with the code. Okay, so I need leaf, I need node. Let's create those. Label. And in the node. Label string. Actually, this should be another Off-tree. Okay, let's adjust the this only a leaf off. It'll be easier to have right. That will take a label and await, and we'll return now label. And I'll have a leaf that will take our data gate. Actually, support. Let's see. Something like this. And this will be reader. Node. Plus no. That will receive Data create of that and a collection of okay. And we need to have a read node. Ouch. Oh, okay. Sorry. Bit confused. Let read node read row test of the test function label sample expected equal test function of label that is receiving a function that doesn't have deposit in it. So expected should supposed to be equal with 3 read node of sample. Okay, so read row test. Puzzle 7. We don't know who the tree is. No more red. So for the moment we didn't progress at all. We have at least some base tests that are failing, and this is a good thing because we know exactly what to do. Let's fix those tests. So, we need an implementation for the read node. Let's see. I don't have a parsec. Let's add it. Oh. Packet. And argument of course test. Okay. Really? Perfect. Yes. Perfect. Well, we think the like this. I need to what? Read the characters. Okay. Let me check. No. So. Any. Some characters. Still, in space. This is one. And those have to be letters. Oh. Sorry, I was interrupted. So I was trying to parse a label. So many, at least one character still so a letter parser and at least a space. Okay. Wait. Between. Oats. Green. Okay. Ouch. Okay. So I have a label, I have a way. What else I have? I have a spaces, at least one space. Or hello. Take the I have already one letter. Separated by a comma, but separated by first thing, yeah, for this thing. That why return Arsenal won. Ars. Ars. Wait. And now optional. Split it quickly parts and tables parts arrow spaces. I have spaces already. So parts arrow. And take the top labels and how was this operator? Was like this? Like this. Come let's do it like that first. Oops. Top labels. And yes, what that would be going on. Was something. I forgot what it was that. Never mind. What I was searching for. So this will return. Oh, I was searching for optional. No, that's right. Not bad. No optional. Okay. We have a top one and also I need to use this operator. Okay. So if I have, actually, I want to this will be a function. That will give me a leaf. I'll give a function that will receive what? A label. A weight. And maybe that. This goes to match with trials with then it's a div of label. Actually, this I can call it data directly. Data. Otherwise, some child is load of data child okay. Oh. That's right. So actually, this does not. I will not, I don't want to have it in the tree. Let's do like this. Okay, let's Oh, I will have a loose node. And this is another concern. Actually, I can do directly like this. So this is another concern. This is actually the lead node. I think actually it's lead nodes. And input type string. Places. Places. Oh, no. Hold on. This one, please. That's this. Hold on, will return now. My result, the result is. I forget the structure. Where I can see a parser over here. Hold on, a parser somewhere. Run or pass the result of volume. Pass the result. Result is the state position. Result is the state and position. Goes to sum of A. And the failure or anything goes to none. And this runner oh, I'm sorry. Those. Option. Nice. What is it? Because the loose node is using data. Okay. Let's not use data. Let's use a string and int. Is I'm still in read the wrong result. Okay. And this will have a width static number from result equal actually, I can do it directly. The function of this node. Label weight. Actually, this is the data. And maybe else. And those two. Come on. Match, maybe else. Wait. Else. Then, I can still not create the tree. Okay. Not satisfied with the result. So those two, I can pipe it to a data. And the loose node then can have a data here, and will remain just like that. For the moment. Data create, sorry. So read nodes. What will do? It's using read rows and is returning an option. I don't need more data. So my test, not a leaf, is a node Oh. Ich dachte, wie ja. Nein. This is the sum. So this will be just now parsing part. I still have an error. So I don't have a read node here. I have a read rows. What was the name please? Let's those and let's see. No. Value. Nice capital. Okay. So I have that. Expect from read rows is returning me a collection. Ouch, God, that is. And that let's see. I need another helper. Helper. Perfect. Don't want a selection or sequence here. Traverse it. Okay. Actually, I don't need to. No lo entiendo. Ja, es ist anderweise. I need to return something here. I'm not happy. I still need to return a list. I don't know exactly the type. And I don't want to return the default value for that type. So I will use the so expect something, expect hold on of let's see. Hold on. And add. I have the item. And I see that is the expected value. With the read row test. I'm sure that I want to limit to just one row. Because I will need to test a collection of games. I don't want to limit just one row. Mal sehen, was da rauf. So. Ach, war Grüßbahn. Then this expected. So this will be the base parts of the test. And I want to have a little more rows. I then put on here 1 point. Sequence equal of as soon as is actual expected, I must say. Okay. Okay. Good. Able to read the rules, failed. So, able to read the rules, failed. The rules in the individual rules succeeded. So, see. Let's make a simple change. Add spaces before and after. How is behaving? So the leaf is failing. And node is failing. Both are failing. Because of the spaces. So, let's see. I think the end spaces are the issue here. What? Yeah, the end spaces are the issue. Run again. Actually, I want to see. I want to sit on both of them. The node is failing. Only the node is failing now. But it's not failing. I can have a space before the leaf, but the node is sensitive. Let's see why. So, parse label. Labels. Okay, let's add a spaces here. That issue. And the parse label. Spaces. Now, let's test it. First label, first weight, optional, but the weight has doesn't have spaces, but the arrow has spaces. So the leaf doesn't like not have. Let's see. Simple one is okay. The node is still failing. I think the label is the issue here. The leaf is the issue. So the leaf will be a parse label. Parse weight. And here I'm using spaces one. Let's use spaces here. Now, my test is something like, so this is covered. What is failing the node? Sample node is failing. So the node doesn't like to have what a space before the label. Okay, let's validate another test. So this will be a skipped test, and will be also skipped. There's noise. And so spaces, letters, space one, no spaces, the weight without spaces. It's creating a spaces that ends in a parenthesis. And then optional parse arrow, and the parse arrow is at least one space. And an optional thing behind it. And I added here a list of spaces after it. Okay, let's add here spaces. Taking this value here to not be do not force spaces and to allow spaces after it. What is the issue now is I'm not enforcing the space. But who cares? Sample node reading two rows. Why is reading the sample node? Why is that? Sample node. So parse label allows to have spaces, then letters. Okay, let's remove this. Those solid covered here. And I have the arrow and a list of 21 cars of letter separated by comma. Has some spaces between those. Yeah. Tam tam tam. This was the issue. I think now it's permissive, but doesn't matter actually. Because I expect that the input data to not be too nice. So I can read. Nice. I can read. I come back to my test. My test. Like this. For the moment, this will be still noise. Okay. So if I can read the thing, what it is, yeah. So I can get a collection of maybe things. I assume that the input is in the correct format. And I use the parser with rows of input, and this will return me an optional thing and option get. And finally, I have a read the result. And I said that I want to make both the tree as a solution and to make the first solution also for the first part. So the first solution. Let's see. I have the rows, and I want to create two collections. So rows. Come on, it's a list. A list. I have. Oh. I have a data item. Maybe. What? Actually, it will be like this. Balance. Equal rows list choose maybe option app. Actually, I don't need to. I already have it. It dot label. Those are the parents. And in the child, I want to create a set. Those. I think. List. Second. And it is a list of lists. So I need to flatten that. I need to create a set. And the root will be parents Paste. Find. The first child. The first parent. That doesn't exist in child. So. That means of x negated. I assume that the input is in a correct format. What is the issue here? Ouch. Okay. So the loose thing, the data and the string list option. The data and the string list option. Oh, yeah, I need to load. Okay. And function of what? But this is an option. Ah, it's okay. So this will be the past implementation. For that, let's run it. Take this value and put it here for a project. Okay, going back with the test. I think I'll make the second part. And I'll come back here. I updated the test. Run it. Everything Fine. And now the second part. Day 7. I need to build a tree. I need to make a dictionary by label and whatever I read from that. Need to write a test. Interesting. We don't know how to write a test. I need to return a value actually. I need to build a tree until I found a difference. I find a child node whose total weight is different than The weights of the other child. Total weights of the other child. So my to create a tree and so after that to make that check. An optimized version would be to make it on the spot, but I think it's easier to create it's easier to implement to create the tree then make that check. Okay. Let's create the tree. This time I will want to have a map. Actually, I will make more maps. Let's see. Data. And childs. And go to table. Actually, I want to run the composite already, so it see, and this will be office. So I have a map, and what I want to do. I want to traverse this map and generate. Another dictionary. Actually, I can do in one step, but no, I think I want to go on this tradition by that's not optimized. How I can find the route? I'm mutable. Don't hate me, but rooms. Sequence. I have another thing. Okay. It's a function that is even fair. What I want to do that what is notation? Yes. Okay. Sorry. This. Okay, let's extract it. Match value. The second and leave. Come on. First. What I do with this? I want to add it to the partial tree. What if I already have that value? So value. Oh. Yeah. And. Don't want to do that case. Ah, I want to I don't want to do anything. I want to save the roots and actually I'm creating something. And if it's false, then I want to check. Then I want to create actually. So I need to check if it's a leaf. And this will be takes the value. Otherwise, I thought it was simply something. So this entire thing actually is a recursive function. Wait, oops. So what I need to do. I first want to check if already exists the partial trees. If exists, then I will return the node. If doesn't exist, I will need to create a collection the code. And if this collection I want to create a new thing. Data. The data is value. First. The node has also and actually this should be an array. Right or not? If that is and partial the node. Okay, this thing can be extracted. So every time I'm returning to poetry for the three childs, and I need to return the route. So for each of those, I want to what? Doesn't have the keys connection. Let's see. Okay, doesn't help. Doesn't matter. Friends, and goes at the root of other third. Okay. One. Okay, I have a value, and if I have a value, I can do data and challenge. Maybe so. And this okay, this is all. Ist auch schon mal. Berlin. Update. Ja, ich würde den ganz schön. Ah. Okay. What a shitty thing. Just to have a just to have the root, not searching after that. So yeah, I parent label is of type string. Get here okay. So if I filter this after what? Actually, this is the last root created. So I suppose that that will be the root of the tree. What I want now. I want to visit the tree and make the sum for the child. So here I could return the node and the total for that node and check in this collection if the child doesn't have the correct weight. And stop on that moment. But I created the tree. Let's use it. Actually, it's not to return the root here. Because I have a generic tree. And find node or root. Absolut. Load. And what I want to do. Give the sum. So this will be root recursive. Node equal. What I want to do? I want to the absence of the value. So match nodes with value of d, then d dot wait, otherwise if it's a node of D and values, I need to mostly return values. Array map compute node weight okay, if right. Distinct. Alright. We got them one. I need to return what? Wait. And Dadurch. So, und I will compute the sum. I will return right false. Already some. And I just need to compute all the weights. And ignore it. And I need to. I don't have an else. I don't want to do finger processes at all. This will be like this. And weights. And I expect that the invalid weights to be sum. So invalid weights option get, and I think it's the first value. Our case, yeah. Okay, let's write a test. Forget about the test. So I have the sample. And I hope that is the same thing. It's a little bit different, the problem. I need to find actually I have the proper node where the childs are unbalanced. So I need to return both the child and the weight. That's I need to find a child that is different from the rest of the parents. And for that particular child, by a predicate. I need to group. An array. What I have a weight and a collection of Childs. And I want to map it to what? Capital. So in this moment, the partition will be a number of items. I'm supposed to have a single record. If I have more records, then this is the faulty thing. And the one with a single is a little bit more complicated, but so if they actually partition. One. Then it's a good thing. Then I just need to return actually, I need the number of the weight. Oh, no, this is the weight. No, I don't need it. I need the number of childs. Then I need to return what? Dot, you know, that is a data, and what was the int? The weight of the child. Second. This is the weight on the child. I need to multiply it by the number of the childs. And I need to add right. It's convoluted, maybe I should just make this, but instead of array sum to array map second, let's do that. So it will be easier to read. Array. Second, take the sum. Okay. And else. Sum by. Okay. Nice. Need to find the only thing that actually this will remain. Second, this will not do anything because actually I'm shooting for a side effect. A side effect will be to update the invalid weights thing. So, otherwise, partitions. Array find actually partitions array partition by what? By number of things. And items. For one. And to type it. Anyway, yay. That. And the faulty I know this data. I know the data of the right ones, the weight of the right ones. I just need to return the delta. Again, the delta is required. What will its weight need to be? What? The faulty one is a delta between the child, the weight of the node minus particular equal. Okay. I have the items. And oh, it's a number. Good. And I heard second. The quality node is right. Don't have to. The test. The test should take what? That sample on input the value is I need to write this test. And find balance and node. A bad name, but oh, root. I need to generate tree that will give me a root and find the balance and node. So I have. I have the sample. I need to generate three to find the balanced node. And yeah, I need to get expected. And this the three options. Yeah, I need to make sure that actually, yeah, I want to like that. a lot nicer like this. Oh, not for that one. Action value. Too high. Okay. I generated the tree, this is can check that. The tree root is the same. Check it actually. So right, that is bug. What's... Venga, tres, seis. Venga, lemon. And it should be the same. I really don't understand. What is happening? In the view? Attention. So the root is fine. I assume that so if I find second. So I'm working by weight. The in my weight, I will have a weight. The tuple of data and so. With that group, I count four items in the group, and return the first thing in the group. Where is my distinct? Ah, okay, so it's a single group. The single group, and I will return the node weight, and the sum of child weights. Otherwise, okay, I know what to do. The change was propagated. That was my issue. Until the top of the root. Okay. So this be the solution for the second part of the puzzle. Run it. Thank you for watching. Tomorrow I will continue with